Thrusting wedge, this is a really good technique. It can work off a shove or it can work off an attempted grab. Remember, it's an attempt. They haven't grabbed us yet. We're going to stop it. We're going to prevent it while it's in the actual act before it finishes up. We're going to thrust our arms up and out, two blocks this way. And I stand sideways. I throw some up and I angle them away from me. I want a point to come up, then lock them out. I close my hands very, very tightly when I'm blocking with my arms. Why? If your hands open and you're blocking with bone, you're going to do damage. But if you make a fist, you're blocking with muscle. I want to protect my arms. I have to use them, and I'm going to be striking with them. I wouldn't take my own bone out and actually hit with it. I don't want to do damage to myself. Most street fight situations, that's exactly what happens. You get in an argument, you get in a fight, you actually do more damage to yourself. Think about it. We actually think a size of a fist is going to fit in somebody's eye. Doesn't even make sense, does it? But we try it all the time. Why? We're not thinking. We're not thinking and we're not responding. This doesn't fit in the eye. That fits in the eye. So that's the tool you use. That's why we have so many different weapons at our fingertips. They're our hands, our arms, our elbows, our knees. You got to learn how to use them. You learn how to use them, you're going to put them in the right situation. Let's look with Sean as you see me going forward. You notice I'm going to be moving forward. That gives you a key right there. Thrust. I have to operate by going forward. I want to stop him in his tracks. Let's look at it. As Sean comes in, he's going to be stepping forward. I can see him coming and his hands are up. Whoa, what's going to happen here? I better meet this halfway. I drive forward right here, taking him out. Notice my hands are closed. Why? I want to block with muscle, not bone. Taking him out. Palm strike right to the collarbone. I want to drive down. I've got to stop this massive motion coming forward. This is going to do it. Good foundation. From here, I can go ahead and execute the following strikes. Come up under the chin. Good control. I can strike completely right here. Taking my hand, palm to the bridge of the nose, clawing if I want to. If I want to make it more severe, I can grab his hair and knee to his face. Thousands of things we can do. Not one's better than the other. It's just whatever you go with. That's what's going to work. Let's try it again. As Sean comes in, I thrust him out, stop him in his tracks. Upper elbows, I shift my weight to a neutral bow. Neutral bow, that allows me to go forward and backwards with equal mobility. It's like putting a car in neutral. You can either shove it or pull it. Striking under the chin. Yeah, I want to do some damage. I'd like to get to his nervous system. How's the fastest way I can get to his nervous system? By breaking his teeth. If I break his teeth, it exposes a nerve. If you knock out a tooth, the nerve comes with it. But if I break his teeth by shoving them up against each other and a nerve is exposed through the break, just the air of breathing is going to put more damage to him. Internally, not externally. Coming up, striking to the bridge of the nose. This is going to cut off the respiratory system. If I broke his teeth, he doesn't want to open his mouth because the air is going to hurt. Now I'm breaking his nose. What's he going to breathe with next? From here, checking it, coming down, clawing the face. Finishing up, checking him off, driving him to the ground. The impact itself can take the air out of him. Take the air out of him. That means I'm forcing it where he's either going to have to use his mouth or his nose to breathe. When the air goes out, from a sudden impact, what comes next? A big inhale. With a big inhale coming, he's going to give himself more pain. He's fighting on my side. That's American Kempo. Get the other guy to defeat himself. Let's look at it again. Sean comes in. I'm going to meet him halfway. Comes in. Take him out. Palm strike. Upper elbow. Palm claw. That's the technique. Drive him. Take him to the ground. Anything that happens down here, you started it, but the force is going to stop it. It's going to be to your advantage, though. Whatever happens, it's in your favor. Let's look at it. Sean comes in. I step in. Take out my base. Block his arm. Upper elbow under the chin. Dropping right here. Clawing the face. Check him off. Right into the ground. Good control. Look what I have. I have everything. I can drag him over to me. I can strike to the back of the head. I can take out the ribs. This is a good technique. The key word is thrust. You've got to drive it. Take it home. This is American Kempo. It works. Saves the streets. Sean comes in. I step in. Take out my base. Block his arm. Upper elbow under the chin. Dropping right here. Clawing to the face. Check him off. Right into the ground.